Hey, this is Wes with Missouri Wind and Solar. We're bringing you an update video today. A couple of years back, I think Jeff did a full-on great video talking about batteries and how they are fit into the mix of things. We've got a new battery that we're showcasing today as part of this, and we wanted to kind of just go back through the batteries and how we look at them, some of the pros and cons on each one of them. Any of the detail on this, if you'd like to see in any more detail, check out our website, windandsolar.com, and we've got all of the infinite details there listed out. What we want to do today is just walk through these three different types. So the three that we've got up here today is our workhorse from thousands of years ago, lead acid, our AGMs, which have been a real stable product that we have used time and time again in our installation, and a new battery for us that we're bringing in here, and we're actually now part of our battery offering, is a Simplify lithium lithium battery. So we've got these three that we're going to talk about today. So let's talk about our first battery here, which is our lead acid battery. And they're kind of iffy if this really happened or not, but there's some supposition that they found the first lead acid battery in a Mesopotamian archaeological dig in Baghdad. So that goes back 2,500 years possibly. May or not be true, but anyway, it's interesting stuff. But that just tells you that technology is incredibly tried and true. And probably the biggest thing about the lead acid that it brings to the table is a low entry cost. So we look at this battery, it's about $300. And it's a technology that we've all grown up with, understand fairly well. The another big pro of it is the voltage input range. So it can take a variety of those. So it's not really particular. It can kind of just take anything that you want to send to it. The cons, one of the big cons with the lead acid battery is that you can sulfate this battery on your first use of it if you're not careful. So it's particularly sensitive to that, and you can break a battery the first day that you've got it. The other issue that we've got with this is weight to watts, and that's one of the things that you could, again, if you go to windandsolar.com, we can show you some of those charts and graphs and how that appears. But as you look at using that battery, if you're in any kind of situation where weight is an issue, then your weight to watts is something you really need to be particular about. The lead acid batteries are they need high maintenance. Again, we've all kind of grown up with this technology. You need to check the water in it. You need to add water. You need to be real particular about that. And again, if you one mess up and basically you could destroy that battery. So you need to be real particular in the maintenance on that. The life expectancy on these as compared to these other batteries is pretty short too. And so that means swapping them out. That means swapping out a big heavy battery. And I know David and I were setting these up here earlier, and we didn't want to put the ones up here on the table just because of the weight on them. And lastly, lead acid, as again, it's one of the common things known about it, is disposal. You know, disposable lead acid battery is challenging, core charges and all that sort of thing. So it's not something that you just, throw in the garbage can and move on. The next battery that we've got up here on the table is our AGM. This is a great battery. We carry these. This is probably, hands down, our most popular battery. The great things about it is that it is incredibly stable, maintenance-free. There's little to no charging resistance on it, and huge resistance to sulfation. This battery is about $650. So it's a great value from that standpoint, particularly on entry into your battery market sort of thing. The cons of it is this thing. I love the batteries, but good God, this thing weighs a ton. I think Crystal looked it up for me a few minutes ago, and David and I were both crying when we had to put it up here on the table. This is like 152 pounds. This battery is not for the faint of heart. And so as you look at that, like we were talking even with the lead acid, getting this into your application, then maintaining it over the years and having to move it, anything like that, man, you do not want to have to move this battery. You don't want to move it the first time, so you certainly don't want to move it the second and third time. The AGM is also sensitive to overcharge, so that's something you've got to be real careful with and make sure that your charge controllers coming in this are correct. And then the last thing is there is some disposal issues with the AGM. And again, this battery is about $650, somewhere in that range. Okay, our last battery that we wanted to bring up today, and this is a new battery that we're carrying. This is a lithium phosphate battery. It's important to bring out the phosphate because we always hear people like, oh my gosh, lithium's gonna blow up or whatever. That's lithium cobalt. This is lithium phosphate. Even though if you look on the box, any of the shipping information, it still has the flame and hazardous material. It's really not. This is a very stable battery. But we brought this into our mix. We've looked at lithium before, and probably the biggest challenge with lithium, up until the point that we've partnered with Simplify, was that the cost on these were phenomenal. They're, people were very proud of these batteries, and looking at them in a per usage cost, it just didn't make sense for most of our customers. Now Simplify has come in with this battery. It's an aggressive price point for lithium, and the benefits that we'll go through right here kind of spell that out. So the biggest benefits are real similar to the AGM overall. So you've got virtually no maintenance. You know, there's actually a built-in maintainer in this. The life cycles on this is tremendous, and we'll talk about that in a minute as far as the lifespan of the battery. Little to no resistance in charging. It is very environmentally friendly as compared to anything else. And our weight to watts on this is incredibly high. So this is an 80-pound battery, and I think we did the math, and it's something, you know, we'll talk about the math in a little bit, but the number of batteries that you would need in each one of these units is significant, particularly in weight, when you compare it to this lithium. There's only two slight cons to it, is the initial cost. This battery we're selling for $23.99. So again, we've got $23.99, we've got $650, we've got $300. You'll see, I mean, that's a big jump, and we'll talk about that in just a second. So the initial buy-in is pretty high, and the voltage input range is, we want to be real specific on that, so you have to be careful with that. So let's break this down a little further and talk about how we evaluated this for cost purposes. So we sat down and we started calculating this out to see what the real value of these batteries are and the value proposition on them. So one of the first things we want to mention when we do this is that we looked at this over a 25-year period. So we talk about a 25-year premium here. And the reason we talk about 25 is that is the expected life expectancy. Sorry, that is the redundancy department there. That is the life expectancy of the Simplify. So what we did is we took a 25-year Simplify, we calculated what a 25-year North Star and what a 25-year Trojan, and basically kind of did the math up to build those up to that. So, and what we also didn't really include in there is a value for the warranty, which is huge. So your Simplify has a 10-year warranty, and both the AGM and the Trojan, the North Star and the Trojan have a 1-year warranty. So that's huge too. There's really not a way to calculate that in there other than you just know you've got a good value for the battery there. So what we didn't calculate in there is the overall headache, downtime, etc. If you have a 25-year battery and you've got, you know, a 6-year battery, obviously that means, you know, 4+ times you're going to have to swap these out while this just sits there and does its job for 25 years. So we didn't come up with a number and say, okay, well, you know, you've got to lug all these batteries out, bring new batteries in. you're going to be down for however long when the battery reaches its end of life and that sort of thing. We didn't calculate that in that. So we really just kind of looked at the usable watts over the 25 years and what that math worked out to be. And before I get that, so one other thing that we want to review on here is the ability to add additional batteries in along the way also. So there's some real basic areas where you can't effectively add batteries in with an AGM and a lead acid, but with a lithium you can. And there's some caveats to that, and I would again direct you to our salespeople or windandsolar.com, and you can find out a little bit more about that. So that's another one of the areas where we really didn't calculate into it, but it is something you definitely want to consider. Well, when we looked at this and we did this 25-year calculation, what we came up with was trying to figure out what battery is the most cost-effective over a period of time. And that's not to say it's not expensive buy-in, just over the lifespan of the batteries, what's the most cost-effective one? And it turns out that it is a Simplify. So if we have one Simplify battery in place, what that leads out to, again, just kind of projecting the math out, is that over that 25-year lifespan, you're going to need a 35% more AGM and a 25% more lead acid to replace that. So for every dollar you've spent with the Simplify battery, you have to spend $1.35 with the AGM, and you got to spend $1.25 with the lead acid. So that's just one of the things that we kind of wanted to break it down and look at this and say, well, you know, we had a lot of issue with some of the more popular brands, the dollar values on them, and what that calculated out to be with them. Then now with the Simplify and the more aggressive price point that they have and program they have, it becomes a lot more cost effective over time. Now, I know our crowd, and we talk with y'all every day, I know spending $2,400 for a battery, I mean, that's a heap of everybody's budget. But when you look at it, if you're looking at your application that you're wanting to spend any time in it, the Simplify is going to be a much more cost-effective battery over time. So that's kind of what we wanted to go over with today. And like I've said multiple times, if you've got more detailed questions, you can always contact our salespeople. You can actually talk with our sales staff. You can call them 417-708-5359. We're at the store 8 to 5 Central Time. You can talk with one of our sales techs and they can walk you through this in more detail. Or always check out our website where all of the basic statistics on these batteries are available there. It's windandsolar.com. This is Wes with Missouri Wind and Solar. Thanks for checking out our video today.